it's not necessarily a book that you'll find in your neighborhood Christian bookstore, but it is indeed theological in essence. A new book that proclaims that there is proof in the Bible that only Israelites can be saved recently hit the shelves. The book entitled Ain't No Salvation for Esau or Gentiles gives an in-depth examination of this doctrine from the perspective of the organization commonly identified as the Black Hebrew Israelites. With us today is the author of the book, Simba Shabunahakunamata of God is Black Ministries, and also joining us today is the Christian Road Warrior, who has some strong criticisms against this book by Simba Shabunahakunamata.
Yeah, real strong criticisms.
Also joining us today is Mr. Ring-ahh-Ding, Ding-ahh-Ling, Shazam, who has expressed some support and encouragement of Simba's book.
Yo, it's your boy Ring-ahh-Ding, Ding-ahh-Ling.
And Shazam is the author of the book, Bad Grammar and Electronics I Love, But Good Christians I Hate. Now, Simba, according to this book that you wrote, the contents in it plainly tells the reader that the Bible proclaims that only Israelites can be saved. Now, how did you possibly come up to that conclusion based on the contents that we see in Revelation and in Isaiah?
Man, that's real simple. You bacon-eating, Sunday worshiper, Edomite, you. The Messiah,
I don't know why he's calling me
in Matthew chapter 10, verse 5 and 6. Go not.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Go not into the way of the Gentiles and into any city of the Samaritans, enter ye not. You know what I'm saying? But go rather unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. All right? So y'all need to listen up. Y'all need to smarten up. All right? The passage, all right, makes it very clear. The Messiah, or who you call Jesus, right, said it himself that he did not intend for salvation to be for the Gentiles or for the Edomites, man, but that is only for the house of Israel. All right, so now we go to John chapter 1, verse 11, where the apostle John made it very clear himself. He said that he came unto his own. Well, who is he talking about? Well, he ain't talking about no Chinese people. He ain't talking about no Moabites. He ain't talking about no Ammonites, no Arabs, no Jewish people, all right? You know, Edomites, no Gentiles, right? He's talking about Israel, black people. Know what I'm saying? He came unto his own. Who is he? Christ. Who did he come unto? His own. What color is his own? Black. Who are his own? Israelites, okay? He ain't come unto no Edomites, no Gentiles. Right? He came onto his own. You know what I'm saying? Oh no, it's wrong with y'all people. But y'all need to smarten up. Precept upon precept. Alright? We got another passage right there. Proof that salvation is just for Israelite. Alright? We got John chapter 4, verse 22. Makes it very clear. He says that salvation is for the Jews. That came right out of the,
you know,
the,
me, Gene,
the Messiah's mouth.
Well, this guy's running his mouth.
Hold on a second, man.
Talking about Edomites or termites or whatever else he thinks.
Yo, how you gonna just cut me off, man? Yo. Let's, yo, we supposed to be having a debate, man. It's my turn to be talking. He just won't do.
Hey,
no warrior,
Simba,
over here just going to start talking.
This ain't no Lion King.
Oh, okay. He got
right
joke.
Now,
he got
I'm joke. About to do to you what
yeah,
I did to your boy over there.
Yo, that's funny.
Ring-ahh-Ding-ahh-Ling,
yeah,
whatever
yeah,
it's called his name.
Yeah, I'm going to let you have. I'm going to get you back,
if
bro. I'm going to get
remember.
You back. Whatever, man.
Don't even have to use a clothesline for this guy.
So you need to read the scriptures, man. That's your problem, man. Cause you over there eating that pork. You looking
hey,
at First
Simba,
Timothy chapter 4.
You better leave my main man,
eating
me
that
Gene
pork.
Alone about that
you need to
pork.
Stop eating that pork, brother.
Before I
you
jump
need to stop eating that pork.
Clothesline you next week.
Up colon, man.
First Timothy
messing you
4,
up.
1 through 5.
You got all that eating my pork.
Clearly
messing
says
up your mind,
that he can eat all the pork
mind.
He wants. Now get a clue before the Road Warrior comes and runs wild on you.
Now, why is that, Mr. Warrior? Why do you reject the contents in this book? I mean, it seems to me that based on the contents of Matthew chapter 10, it seems legitimate.
Why do I reject?
I don't know why he's calling
me. Let me tell you something, Gene. You know, this guy's going to look worse than he does now when I'm done with him. He already looks like he's wearing his mama's pantyhose and a belt on his head. This guy has no clue what he's talking about. He's just going
he's
around
doing
cool scriptures out of context.
I can't listen to this. Man, what you talking
up.
About, bro? Man, I just showed you all the scriptures,
away.
Man. I can't help you too blind to see
right
the truth.
Now.
All right? I just showed you the scriptures, man. I gave you Matthew chapter 10, John
truth.
Chapter 1, John chapter 4. Man, I can't help you too blind to see, man. You need to stop eating all that pork. Man,
because
that pork is poisoning your mind, brother. Maybe you need to get some shades with the scripture, man.
Reading
get some shades with the scripture.
Why don't you try reading First Timothy?
I don't know what you trying to read the Bible shades on
there.
What's wrong with you?
About Mr. Road Warrior, not that it's at all relevant to the discussion, but those spikes on your shoulders do seem to be pretty intimidating. And my name is not Mean Gene. But anyway, Road Warrior, I was saying
I'm the Christian
that you
Road
think
Warrior. And if I say your name's Mean Gene, then that's your name. Got it? You don't want me coming over there and slapping some biblical sense into you.
Well, that's interesting. But anyway, RoadWire, are you saying that there is absolutely no support in the Bible that supports Simba's argument? I mean, Simba does seem to have a legitimate argument here based on what we see in Matthew chapter 10, verses 5 to 6. I mean, they do clearly state that Jesus told the disciples to not go to the Gentiles, but only to the Israelites. Now, how can you possibly refute this argument, Mr. Road Warrior? How can you refute this?
Hey, Simba Foon over there gave you a gross distortion of scripture. And let me elaborate. Hey, elaborate. That's a pretty nice size word for the warrior. Let me elaborate on the facts. Fact number one. If the Gentiles were not to be saved, then why did Jesus go on to say in Matthew 10:18 that the apostles would be a witness to the Gentiles? Oops. I guess Simba Foon didn't read that far.
Well, you know, yeah.
And what about
Luke 2:32? He doesn't seem to know how to read very well.
As
you know,
Jesus
especially after John chapter
dedicated
4, verse 22.
In Jerusalem. Yeah. And Simon said, listen to the warrior. Just kidding. And Simon said that Jesus would be a light to the Gentiles. And
then
the glory of his people.
Because he don't know no precept upon precept. Because he only know that the word is there. Because he got
Let me finish. In John 1:11, we have the general statement about the fact that the Jews or the Hebrews didn't all accept Jesus as their Messiah. However, the very next verse, verse 12, goes on to say, but as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become the children of God, to those who believe in his name. And that passage does not exclude anyone.
Preach it, brother. Preach it.
And that includes the Gentiles.
Can I get an amen?
Yeah. Fact number three. I hope these guys can keep up with the counting here. The very passage that Simba Foon tries to use in John 4 refutes his claims. For example, if salvation was only for the Jews, then why didn't Jesus say for? Guys trying to put words in Jesus' mouth. I ought to come over there and crack his neck right now. But the warrior's trying to calm down and be relaxed. Anyway, no. Jesus used the Greek word ek, meaning out of the Jews. Meaning from out of the Jews. God used the Jews to bring the good news to the world. Yet the fact that this news was not just for the Jews is proven by the fact that he was there offering a Gentile the truth.
How are you supposed to take somebody like that seriously, man?
When you go down in chapter 4 to verse 39, it says that many Samaritans or Gentiles
believed
in Jesus. He even stayed there 2 extra days at their request. Now, if salvation is not also for the Gentiles, then why did he stay and cause more to believe in him? You know me, Gene. This is what I call the 1, 2, 3 lights out. It's over for this guy, Simba Foon. What a rush.
Excellent, excellent. Can I get an amen? Can I get an amen? And I'm not me, Gene. But anyway, that sounds to me like a sound argument, Simba. Do you have any good, reasonable, and rational responses to this comment by Roy?
Let me say something, man. Obviously, this man's mind has been poisoned by all that bacon he's been eating and all that Sunday worship and indoctrination that he's been going through, all right? And it's the same pork that's causing him to worship a white Edomite Jesus, man. But hey, what do you expect for somebody, you know what I'm saying, who missed the who looks like he missed the audition for Mad Max back in the 80s? He can't let go, you know what I'm saying?
Hey,
but anyway,
Simba Foon.
I'm going to get back
still
to my point.
Read
No, hold on a second,
yet,
man.
Huh?
Let him finish. Let's just move on.
Who published your book anyway? Was it Rakifi or Mufasa?
That's good. That's really
the problem with this guy's interpretation is that he neglects the fact that when we see Gentiles, it's really talking about the scattered sheep of the house of Israel. All right, that's what it's talking about. All right, now the Israelites that were scattered because they were scattered because of the curse. You know what I'm saying? And when they went into different parts of the world, all right, they grew accustomed to the cultures and the traditions of the captives of the Gentile nations that they were captive in. Okay, they then called themselves Gentiles, and the Israelites that still kept their identity, they called them Gentiles as well because they were so captive by the Gentile traditions. All right, so whenever we see the word Gentile, okay, it's talking about the house of Israel. It's talking about the lost sheep that was scattered all over the place. All right, because they lost their identity. That's what it's talking about, Gentiles. It ain't talking about no white man and no Edomites, all right? No Chinese people, no Arabs, no Africans, all right? It's talking about the house of Israel, the lost sheep that lost the identity, okay? That's what it's talking about.
You know, that's an interesting take on the term Gentiles. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I was always under the impression that the term Gentiles was very specific and that it was only referring to individuals that were non-Israelite by blood. But anyway, I do apologize, Mr. Ring-ahh-Ding-ding-ling. I almost forgot that you are here with us. you haven't had much to say, so I'm interested in hearing your take on this issue.
Yo, it's your boy Ring-ahh-Ding-ding-ah-Ling, back with a new electronic device and more accusations against Christians.
Mr. Ding-ahh-Ling, do you have anything to add to the discussion at all? Based on what Simba and Christian RoadWarrior are saying.
All I got to say is this. I got a new video that talks about this new HD video camera I got yesterday. You understand? And I'm going to use it to lump more false Christians with true Christians. I'm also working on a video about this new HD video camera that records in 1080p. But unfortunately, it eats up too much RAM, you understand? But that's alright, because tomorrow I'm making another video about a new high-performance, dual-bay, external hard drive that I'm going to use to save the HD quality 1080p videos on. Wait a minute. You understand?
Uh-huh.
Hey, Simba, that's your boy, Ringling Stupid Brothers, right? Ring-ahh-Ding-ahh-Ling-ahh-Ling-ah, or whatever his name is. Still stuck on stupid, right? Hey, I call him Ringling Brothers because he's like a clown in the Hebrew Israelite circus.
Okay, then. But anyway, back to the discussion. Mr. RoadWarrior, and before you begin, I'd like to preemptively suggest again that my name is not Mean Jane, okay? But anyway, what say you about the comment by Simba about the Israelites being Gentiles? I mean, it seems to me that he's stating that the Gentiles that can and will be saved are not biological Gentiles, but that they're actually the diaspora that have adapted and adopted to the cultures, traditions, and languages of their Gentile captors.
The warrior has learned to be patient, and I gotta be patient, because, you know, the warrior might use the dual-blade of vice and lay you out for contradicting the warrior on national television. But nevertheless, let me stick to the point and get to the point. The simple fact is that this guy Simba Foon here has no clue what he's talking about. How in the world are the scriptures going to make a distinction between Israel and the Gentiles by using two separate words?
How
if there's no distinction, that makes no sense. It makes no sense whatsoever. You see, Mean Gene, if that were the case, then why do the scriptures make the Israel-Gentile distinction in so many passages like Luke 2:32?
I can't trust
Acts
nobody.
4:37.
Yo, America, see, how
this
guy is
making
trust
stuff
shade,
up
man.
Off the top of his
shades, man.
Pantyhose belt-wearing head. And he has no clue what he's talking about because he just doesn't want to face the truth. He can't handle the truth.
Man,
the warriors dish it out.
They should call him the Crispy Road Warrior. That's what he should call him. The Crispy Roach Warrior. That's what he should call him. I'm going to call him Crispy Roach. That's what
you
need to be called, man.
I've had enough of you,
Simba. Because you're a roach.
I'm coming to get you right now.
Okay, that's nice. I'll be Mr. Warrior. Where you go?
I know he ain't coming over here. He ain't coming over.
I'm not exactly sure where Christian Road Warrior is going.
Man, I got my boys.
Maybe he's going to get on the next plane to kick Mr. Simba's rear end.
Whatever, man. Yo, for real.
Well, just a little levity to keep the tension. But anyway, Mr. Ding-ahh-Ling, anything you want to add to this before we end tonight?
Man, I'm telling you, man, I hate Christians with a passion. You understand? That's why I always lump them in with false teachers and make high-quality videos about it. But yo, y'all should check out my new video. It's me playing Grand Theft Auto 8, yo. Man, I be blasting them cops and them hookers with my AK.
Brother, I know you support my book and everything, and I appreciate that. I thank you for that. But I gotta ask you, brother, are you always a Ding-ahh-Ling? Or is it only after you say Shazam?
Well, I want to thank you both, Simba Shabunahakunamata and Christian Road Warrior, and also our special guest, Ring-ahh-Ding, Ding-ahh-Ling, Shazam, for joining us today on our show. We'd love to have you come back again so we can talk about another discussion. And all to the rest of you for joining us today, we thank you, and God bless. I'm going to need that Kool-Aid now.
I've forgotten about you too, Ring-ahh-Ding-ahh-Ling. You're mine too.